Waging War on Corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Produced a special report that's extremely powerful, dealing with mind control and controlled state-run media. That's coming up at the bottom of the hour. I know a lot of stations join us in the second and third hour. We're into the second hour now. I want to give the phone number out at the start of the next segment and take phone calls as well. The establishment basically says, hey, just take whatever we do, accept it, everything will be okay. No, everything won't be okay, because the status quo is about deconstructing basic liberty so that we can all be controlled. Revealed, hacked nude celebrity photos had been on deep web, black market, for a week. And there could be even more to come as they shopped them for sale. Jihadis launch attacks from Pakistan to North Africa. I want to do a special report for the nightly news tonight, where I get up there with the big maps and explain it to everybody. And soon I'm going to move in the big studio over there so I can, during the radio/TV show, get up with a headset and go around and with a clicker, like a weatherman, go through all these exhibits for people, because it's important to see it. But Pakistan has been putting up with so much New World Order garbage. Our government, since 9/11, bipartisan, has been in there trying to overthrow their secular government and overthrow their military. That's been one of the only countries long-running that stopped the New World Order taking them over. And I'm not romanticizing Pakistan. It's got corruption and its own problems. But they brought the 40,000 jihadis in to U.S. bases in Pakistan after 9/11. The real al-Qaeda and Taliban was picked up, brought in to start destabilization over there. And then the globalists hit one button, and their jihadis all over the world start blowing stuff up, attacking, trying to take over Pakistani military bases and media complexes. Again, then the West will come in and bomb those very people posing as the savior, which further stirs people up against the Pakistani government, saying, do something about this, stop working with America. But Pakistan's playing the same double game. So you could argue the only way to survive this is being Machiavelli. But at a certain point, it gets so Machiavellian that there is no policy anymore. And I'm not defending the Pakistani leader either. It's a very complex situation. It's just that you see the Arab Spring being stirred up by Google, by MI6, by the State Department. And we told you that 4 years ago when it all started. It's now admitted that they saw the revolutions coming. So using social media and allowing the groups they wanted to operate and to recruit, they basically steered the dam that had already broken for revolution. They steered the water where they wanted it to go. That's the best way to describe it. They ride the bucking bronco, and they study it. Everything we face is scientific social control. So, in fact, what I'm going to do is I'm going to air the Darren McBrain piece when we come back. And then we will go to your phone calls. I think that's the best way to do it. I want to hear from first-time callers about what do you think the most important issue is out there right now? Or is it the fact that they're trying to stimulate mega crises across the board? And that it's that attempt to create the global crisis to bring in the world government, as Henry Kissinger just wrote in the Wall Street Journal last week. How do you stop something like that? How do you get the public to see outside the box? Because it's a mind trick. Once you get outside of it, you're like, how did that ever fool me to begin with? It's like the Matrix.
After consulting top doctors, nutritionists, pharmacists, and others, we have developed what I believe is the ultimate non-GMO organic Super Male Vitality formula. Super Male Vitality by InfoWars Life is so powerful that I only take half the recommended dose.
I jump out of bed ready to fight these criminals every day. I look forward to waking up and taking my Super Male Vitality.
Visit InfoWarsLife.com today to secure your Super Male Vitality and other powerful products from InfoWars Life.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel body armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel body armor just won't quit.
This is Scottish John for InfoWars.com. I know that most of you here in this commercial already know about the New World Order, eugenics, and all the other issues covered here at InfoWars. The question is, do your friends and family know? If not, then I want to know why. Oh, I know it's tough to talk about this with some people. They might call you names, or they just want to talk about sports or soap operas. I say, so what? There's a battle going on out there right now. The ammunition is information, and the soldiers are you. It's time to transform your game from passive listener to active participant. We from Scotland have had our skin in this game for the greater part of the last 1,000 years, and I'm still fighting. If we don't all stand up right now, we're going to lose everything. The InfoWar is worldwide. Tell your friends about InfoWars and let them know that InfoWars doesn't print bull. It's real journalism and news backed up by documented fact. Step up and take your friends and family to InfoWars.com, PrisonPlanet.tv, and PlanetInfoWars.com. The truth will set them free.
From the water table to our soils to the atmosphere itself, our world is becoming more and more toxic each and every day. But it's not just the air outside that's toxic. Indoor air has been shown to have 2 to 5 times higher concentrations of pollutants than even outdoor air. And most Americans spend 90% of their time inside using toxic chemicals within their homes. There are more than 42 million smokers in the United States. Well over 1,000 types of mold and mildew linked to numerous conditions. And don't forget the fact that 6 million Americans live with pets they're allergic to as well. When I began to research these statistics, it was clear to me it was time to start cleansing my lungs in order to combat the toxic environment that we cannot escape, but that we can fight back against. Made with organic and wild cultivated herbs and manufactured in the USA, the new InfoWars Life Lung Cleanse is here in a convenient spray bottle that can be brought with you throughout any toxic environment. Now available exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.
Aldous Huxley, the author of A Brave New World, he said in an interview back in 1958 that the social engineers of the future, they will figure out a way to enslave us by tricking us and conditioning all of us into thinking that we are actually free. This was also well thought out and researched by the father of propaganda, Edward Bernays, who in his 1928 book, Propaganda, Bernays wrote, "If we understand the mechanisms and motives of the group mind, it is now possible
to control and regiment the masses according to our will without them knowing it."
He called it the engineering of consent and proposed that those who
manipulate this unseen mechanism of society constitute an invisible government, which is the true ruling power of our country.
That's right.
So are we living in an Orwellian nightmare that was prophesied by the likes of George Orwell, Aldous Huxley, and Edward Bernays? Well, I did some research and I put together some video clips that shows how the globalist mind control has been present in our everyday lives, our entire lives, because the future is now.
You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. We're live on the second day of September.
If you want to preserve your power indefinitely, you have to get the consent of the ruled. And this they will do, partly by drugs, as I foresaw in Brave New World, partly by these new techniques of propaganda. They will do it by bypassing the sort of rational side of man and appealing to his subconscious and his deeper emotions and his physiology even, and so making him actually love his slavery. I mean, I think this is the danger, that actually people may be in some ways happy under the new regime, but they will be happy in a situation where they oughtn't to be happy.
This is The Big Picture, an official television report to the nation from the United States Army.
Yes, in modern warfare, our military leaders are finding that words and ideas are highly effective weapons. Here, recruits with specialized backgrounds were taught the nature, methods, and techniques of propaganda and its dissemination. Radio presents these facts in any number of ways. Perhaps its most rewarding form of expression is news. For news is ready-made propaganda. And to an enemy, denied access to outside information, it's as welcome as food and water. Radio's principal advantage is that it can reach remote areas and reach them quickly. So that one program can be repeated and thereby reach a larger audience, it is often recorded on discs or on tape. The same show can be rebroadcast at convenient times in different areas.
Unfortunately, you've grown up hearing voices that incessantly warn of government as nothing more than some separate, sinister entity that's at the root of all our problems. They'll warn that tyranny's always lurking just around the corner. You should reject these voices.
Public policy could itself become the captive of a scientific, technological elite.
My team, my specialties, information operations and the psychological arm of things, we are trained to deceive if we have to.
If you found out that your public affairs team that was showing you around actually had just had completed a 40-hour course in psychological operations and was trained in psyops and in military deception, you start to question, hey, is that an appropriate use of that resource?
You shouldn't trust me. In fact, by my actually participating in that, I will taint the news.
They took the babies out of the incubators. Took the incubators and left the children to die on the cold floor.
And they had kids in incubators, and they were thrown out of the incubators so that Kuwait could be systematically dismantled.
Go read a book by the father of modern advertising, Edward Bernays, where he calls you a dumb slave and admits they run your whole life. I've read both his major books. One of them's called Propaganda. Edward Bernays.
Psychological warfare operations went into high gear. Our propaganda was beginning to pay off.
There's a global crime syndicate that controls NATO and the major Western governments, and it is using Al-Qaeda to overthrow secular governments.
I also can't see sending my son to fight with Islamic rebels against Christians. I also can't see my son going to fight with on the same side as Al-Qaeda.
The people we are fighting today, we funded 20 years ago.
It was almost as if it were a planned implosion. It just pancakes.
Well, pancaking almost like a precision implosion.
Everybody get away from the tower! Everybody get away from the tower. You got another tower that just came down 1013. Where exactly are you, King?
Millions of people are sick and tired of the endless wars, the poverty that is coming, the attacks of our civil liberties.
I don't believe in conspiracy theories.
Conspiracies, yes. If I believe it, there's nothing theory about it.
You take the blue pill, the story ends. You wake up in your bed and believe whatever you want to believe. You take the red pill, you stay in Wonderland. And I show you how deep the rabbit hole goes.
Meantime, there are questions multiplying today about the mysterious death of award-winning journalist Michael Hastings.
We are also requesting that your team of advisors include a senior officer who is thoroughly experienced in psychological operations.
Psychological warfare was established as a special staff agency. This move had far-reaching results.
Do you consider yourself a mark?
Well, I would very definitely say that I am a mark. That is correct.
This American citizen, Obama, depends on your next decision.
What if the whole purpose of government was to negate freedom?
What if freedom was a myth? What if the Constitution meant nothing?